Ladies and gentlemen, the cadets you see marching onto the parade ground are squadron markers, taking their positions. The rest of the squadrons will soon enter the parade ground from the quartermaster's fort. They will move to the left and to the right of the parade ground and then line up squadron-wise. The sequence of the squadron positioning, starting from our left, is based on the overall order of merit that each squadron attained in the inter-squadron competitions last term. Ladies and gentlemen, if you kindly look towards the quarterdeck, you will see cadets marching smartly. Approaching the quarterdeck are the cane escorts and the table orderlies. They will escort the VIPs to the quarterdeck. Going back to the genesis of this institution, the National Defence Academy came into being at Kharakwasla in 1955. Kharakwasla was chosen as the site on account of its proximity to an operational airfield at Pune, its closeness to the sea, the presence of a lake nearby, plenty of area for military training, and of course, its salubrious climate. Today, there are 854 cadets on parade. Out of these, 315 cadets of the 130th course will pass out of the National Defence Academy.
The sound of the bugles, ladies and gentlemen, signals the entry of the cadets onto the parade ground.
Nishan, Tolan! Nishan! Breakfast!
Nishan, Tolan! Majesan! Tachan!
Ladies and gentlemen, Air Vice Marshal Sandesh Wagle, Vayu Sena Medal, Deputy Commandant and Chief Instructor, National Defence Academy.
Gentlemen, Vice Admiral G. Ashok Kumar, Ati Vishesh Seva Medal, Vishesh Seva Medal, Commandant, National Defence Academy.
Hello!
Ladies and gentlemen, Air Marshal Ajit S. Bhosle, Ati Vishisht Seva Medal, Vishisht Seva Medal, Officiating Chief of Integrated Defence Staff to the Chairman, Chiefs of Staff Committee.
Gentlemen, Lieutenant General Bipin Rawat, Uttam Yudh Seva Medal, Ati Vishish Seva Medal, Yudh Seva Medal, Sena Medal, Vishish Seva Medal, General Officer Commanding in Chief, Southern Command.
Thank you. Commander Atul Sinha and Lieutenant Commander Farooq Tarapur represented India in yachting and sailing in the 16th Asian Games in China.
Kalamat, Ted Charlson, Mazak the Gold, Bessas Gordon, again, Brad, the North in Mesa, Nets the Gold, the North, Mon.
these young men is evident as they march forward to receive their well-deserved awards. The reviewing officer is now requested to present medals to the award winners and the Chiefs of Staff banner to the champion squadron of this term. Winner of the President's Gold Medal, Academy Cadet Captain Avinash Chetri. Winner of the silver medal, Academy Cadet Adjutant Avinash Pandey. Winner of the bronze medal, Battalion Cadet Captain Naman Bhatt. Winner of the Chiefs of Staff banner, November Squadron.
Vice Admiral G. Ashok Kumar, Commandant of the National Defence Academy, Deputy Commandant, members of the faculty and staff, proud parents, distinguished guests, diplomats, attaches, cadets on parade, members of the media, ladies and gentlemen, it is an honour and privilege to review the parade of the 130th Corps who are passing out of this cradle of military leadership. Cadets, your impeccable turnout and outstanding display of drill has been a feast for my eyes and of all those who are witnessing this parade today. Almost four decades ago, I too walked past this hallowed quarterdeck that has motivated all of us to give our best in the service of our great nation. The vision of Sri Jawaharlal Nehru, our first Prime Minister, has fructified in building this academy into a living monument, I believe has come to fruition in all such bright young men who carry forward the mission of being the guardians of the nation's security and sovereignty. Parents, your hearts must be filled with pride to see your wards smartly turned out in their uniform and at the threshold of a great career ahead. But I must tell you that the nation is beholden to you for sending your sons to the armed forces when they could have made it to other professions where greed for lucre reigns. That they have chosen to sacrifice the comforts of home and hearth to undergo rigorous training for 3 years and then to move on to even tougher challenges that deprive them the luxuries of life, only to sacrifice themselves at the altar of service to the nation is indeed laudable. It is an outstanding example of the National Defence Academy motto, service before self. I am sure, cadets, that you will be great leaders of men who, with your valour and courage of sacrifice, will make the nation and your parents truly proud in the times to come. Cadets, our armed forces must emphasize are second to none in the world. In matters of war fighting and in ethos of soldiering, they stand heads and shoulders above the rest. Besides, they are a bastion of all that is good in society, be it the moral values of honesty and integrity of character, or the democratic values of secularism and unity in diversity. And the nation has always turned to them in times of crisis, be it in war, proxy war, internal security requirements of insurgency, left-wing extremism, civil disorder, the natural calamities within our borders or in the neighborhood. It is to our credit that we have handled all these situations in a responsible and mature manner, always and every time. The people of our nation have always looked upon us with a sense of pride and respect. We must always conduct ourselves with dignity, upholding moral values ingrained in us, stand steadfast in character, and never, never ever hesitate to display courage, valor, and sacrifice, even to sacrifice our lives should the situation so demand. I must remind you that the armed forces of the world are technology-driven. Non-contact warfare is emerging as a force that will complement hard power in conventional wars. This is an age of cyber and information warfare, and I am happy to say that the Indian Armed Forces are preparing to meet this challenge. We are no longer a rudimentary fighting force that depends on human resources alone to carry out our mission. Technology is the force multiplier, and therefore, without a doubt, each one of us must be technological savvy. This requires not only building our technological capabilities, but also training men to use them. Therefore, I urge you, cadets, never to be complacent about updating yourself with the latest in your services. For as the old adage goes, knowledge is power. I am glad that NDA is making rapid strides and cadets in future will have better orientation to technology. That indeed is a welcome step. However, I must reiterate that we are not for producing armchair warriors. Instead, each of us must be battle-worthy by being physically fit and strong, capable of doing tasks that we expect our men to do, whether it be on a tank, aboard a ship, a fighter jet, or on our feet. Today, India stands at the crossroads of an exciting future. The world is looking up to India as a country that can take a fair share of the responsibility in the comity of nations, whether it be doing duty as peacekeepers for the United Nations, providing goods and services to the world, or in matters of environmental concern. And as an upholder of democratic values, our nation holds a status that every Indian can justifiably feel proud of. Cadets, I assure you that you have a great future ahead. You need to, however, grab the future with both hands, because you are the makers of your own destiny and the destiny of our nation. In your inner man lies the courage to do battle, to face testing times, and to forge ahead without so much as battling an island. Listen to the conscience in the inner man and always do what is right, for that alone will serve your interests rather than the ways of the world. Success follows hard work, patience and perseverance, and playing by the rules. I know that you have been trained to be a leader, a man who stands above the rest. But I say to you, leadership lies in serving others, in looking out for the interest of others rather than your own. Leadership lies in leading from the front and setting an example for those under you in word and deed, and doing the harder right instead of the easier wrong. We stand proud today because of the courage, valor and sacrifice of those who have dedicated themselves in service of our nation, whose names are enshrined in the hut of remembrance. The glory that is ours today is rightfully theirs, and we salute them all. To those from friendly foreign countries, I convey my best wishes and compliments. The training and values of the National Defence Academy will hold you in good stead wherever you lead your men in peace or in war. I wish you all the very best for a very bright future ahead. May the heavens shower its blessings on you. Jai Hind.
Thank you. 10 push-ups. One!
Ready!